today's web interview, we have Mr. Madan Mohan with us. He is an electrical engineer. He has around 15 years of experience. Apart from his professional career as a design engineer for various things in electrical industry, he started HIE, Hyderabad Institute of Electrical Engineers. So we can say he is the founder. It has a very good experience for sharing knowledge, practical knowledge to the people. So there are so many students, professionals got benefited from this institution. Yeah, his vision is very nice. So who are watching this video, you can watch this till the end. You can get a good understanding about what is HIEE, what they are doing, what is their vision, what is their curriculum, what things they are teaching, what practical stuff they are teaching. So how they are offering jobs and all, what is the placement strategy, so how companies approaching them, how they are approaching companies for recruitment and all, what support they are providing, what is the course duration and all, everything he explained in a clear manner so that any engineer can understand easily. So they are providing lifetime support also. I mean, after joining there, it's not the end. They are providing good support also for your entire career, wherever you need any stuff, any doubts or anything related to technical and all. So we have very good interactive session. So keep watching. I hope this interview will give some good understanding to you. Yeah, any professional who are in the electrical industry, they can watch this video. Our discussion is very good. Yeah, apart from my education, he's a very good human being also, for in a supportive manner. Yeah, thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Keep watch till the end, so you can get a better understanding. If you have any questions or comments, anything about this video, you can comment in comment section. I am ready to help you. If you didn't subscribe to this channel, please subscribe to this so that you can get notifications whenever I'm uploading the videos. Keep watching. Very nice. So, first time I'm watching you.
Yes. Nice meeting you.
Yeah, nice to meet you. Welcome to our channel, ALP Talks.
Thank you, Mr. Yeah. Ambati Lakshmapati Garu.
Yeah, very nice.
Actually, it's a nice idea and it's a very good concept. I like it, actually.
Yeah, I am so happy to meet you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, so, simply speaking, there are so many software institutes for teaching Java, Python, C and everything. But I didn't thought of, because myself being electrical graduate, I don't have any thought like that. Someone is offering like this. I don't know. I don't have any thought like that.
See, actually, I feel very proud to say like we are the monopoly in India who trains on electrical system design.
Yes, yes, yes. That's true.
Okay. So in that way, I'm very happy to be as an electrical engineer, to start my career in electrical engineering. And I think like I'm fulfilling my
dreams, happiness,
my dreams in terms of empowering electrical engineers.
That's true.
I almost like trained almost like 5,000 students so far. Yeah. And successfully 4,000 students got placed in a different organizations. That is our success story.
Very nice. Very nice. Yeah. It is going to give future to many people also, many students. Sometimes some people will change careers also, one field to other field. They also take these courses and they can get some good experience. Yeah, it's a wonderful thing. Because in education, whatever we will study, we don't know so many things. It's like whatever we studied, that is complete. For example, myself, I can't say I am a gold medalist. I don't know anything. I am a gold medalist from Pullaredi Engineering College, JNT, Anantapur. Electrical background.
But myself still feel that so many things are there. If any, for example, my child asked me, what is current daddy? How I light will glow? How I can explain? He is 3 years old. What I can say to you?
But it's a great thing. It's a great thing, like being a 3 years old child, he, at least he's getting that doubt. When a BTech passed out guy is not getting the same doubt, that is unfortunate thing is happening.
Yeah, you can see some of videos also, because you are also Telugu. My son, I have that, I am blessed, I can say. My son is question bank. So many questions he will keep on ask.
No, he is son of electrical engineer. That's the reason he is asking.
We will jump into our discussion topic. Yeah, it's a very good. Yeah, welcome again. So, how are you? How things going on there, Nederbad?
I'm very good, and things are going on in a great way after COVID conditions. And just recently, we started offline training too.
Okay.
Almost like 70 students are going have joined with our latest in the recent batch.
Okay.
So, things are moving back again.
Okay.
It's a good.
Yeah. So, how much experience you have for you? For example, yeah, you are electrical. That's anyhow confirmed.
It's a fluent.
Fluent thing. Nothing to ask again. But a little bit about your educational and professional background. So,
coming to my professional background, like I'm BTech graduate, passed out in 2005.
Mm-hmm.
So I have total 15 years of experience into various fields. Like I started my career with a switchgear panel design.
Okay.
And after that, from switchgear panel design, I moved to substation design.
Mm-hmm.
I have experience into AIS and GIS substations up to 220 kV.
Mm-hmm.
And also I work for various oil and gas projects, and I also work for solar rooftop and ground mount systems. Almost, I can say proudly, like almost 500 megawatt ground mount system and almost 50 megawatt rooftop system I executed and designed.
Okay.
So this is my professional background. And also I work with prestigious companies like L&T. I was there in Qatar, worked for GIS substations.
Yeah.
And also I work for Toshiba Mitsubishi Industrial Corporation.
Okay. Okay.
So that is how I can tell, like I blessed to work with these kind of reputed companies.
Yes. Yeah. So what about this HIE? You are a chief mentor, right? Yeah.
Yes. Actually, I just want to tell you a story about HIE.
Yes. Like how we want to know. Process, yes.
How the thought process came to my mind and how it got executed and all.
Mm-hmm.
See, the thing is like as everybody feels after completion of BTech, as you know very well, like whoever is finishing their BTech, like people are coming out with a zero knowledge.
Yes.
That's zero true. Knowledge in the sense like people don't know the industrial requirement. People are not aware like what companies are offering the job and how to get the job.
Yeah.
And if somebody is calling you for the interview, like people are utterly failed. Like if somebody asks you, like, can you tell me about yourself? Even people are not able to convey in a proper way.
That's true.
This is one thing. And because of lack of clarity and a lack of awareness, different potential people are entering into different improper sectors like a telecom, GIS, and few people are entering into software. After a diploma and a BTech and MTech in electrical, people are simply moving to software, and they could not adjust in the software. After 2 years, 3 years, they realized like this is not our right core field. Again, they're coming out from the software and they're leaving like a blank. So because again, after 3 years, they are coming out from any industry, irrelevant industry. Then again, electrical people consider them as a freshers.
That's true.
So I have so many of my friends like that,
mm-hmm.
who entered into irrelevant fields and they work for 2-3 years due to their financial constraints. After 3 years or 4 years, they realized and they come back again.
Yeah.
And they I have seen how they are struggling to get a job in electrical after that.
Yeah.
So, but fortunately, in my case, I'm very happy in that way. Like, I got a job in one company called SSL Tech Private Limited. They are into switchgear panel designing and manufacturing.
Mm-hmm.
So, even though I started my career with a 4,000 rupees as a starting salary, but I was in the right track.
Yeah.
That is how it helped me to grow in my professional career. Yeah. So, with that thought process, like, so whatever I said so far, why people are going into irrelevant fields because of lack of clarity and lack of awareness, and people doesn't have what the industry is expecting from the electrical PALGO students.
Yes, yes.
So with that idea, like, I thought, like, I have some experience. I worked for, after my almost, I started this in 2010.
Mm-hmm.
So after my 5 years of experience, I thought, like, so why don't we share our knowledge, whatever the knowledge we got in the industry. So let's share to the people so that they can get benefit out of it.
That's true.
So with that service motive, we started HRW.
Okay. Is only you founded, or any other friends also started?
Actually, HRW founded, myself and one of my friend, Mr. Sridhar Tokala.
Mm-hmm.
Both we started HRW, actually.
Okay.
And so we it was a journey of almost like 11 years.
Okay. So you both have only this as the job, or any other things?
No, actually, I used to take care of all the classes and technical part. I used to deal, like, taking the classes and conducting the interviews and all the stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to take the classes in the morning, and in addition with that, I used to do the job.
Yes. Yeah, I see.
But I almost did in the same way, like, almost 8 to 9 years.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So just 2 years back, I left my job, and I resigned my job as a senior manager for a company called Think Energy. They are into solar
rooftop. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I resigned my job, and my time is dedicated to institute to make it success.
Yeah. Okay.
This is what the background of HRW.
It's very nice that. So you are only your thought is started this. So it is enlightening many people's dreams.
It is. Yes, actually, I'm telling you very frankly, this is giving me a lot of satisfaction. Like, when we are giving so people training to the people, and after completion of training, at least some 50 to 60% of the people will get the job by end of 2 months training.
That's true.
Okay, so when they are pursuing the training itself, the people will get the job. And when people are taking their offer letters and coming to my cabin, and happily they are saying, like, sir, I got job because of your training, because of your inputs. So I think that is enough for my life to say thanks to God, because that is enough being an electrical engineer. I thought, like, I'm doing my job well.
That's nice. Myself feeling good with myself feeling very nice after starting this YouTube channel, because I have so many people are feeling happy with my content. They are enjoying a lot, so I am getting very peaceful sleep also. Even though it is 5 or 6 hours, it's very wonderful. I can say I'm happy.
Exactly, because see, there is one sentence in the movie, like, you have to give something to the society. Same way, like, whatever I learned, whatever I explored in my 15 years of experience, I just designed a curriculum in such a way a fresher can get 2 to 3 years experience in 2 months.
That is what
the knowledge we are giving to the people. We are training to the fresh electrical graduates, whatever the things I learned after my 10 years of experience.
That's true. Actually,
so in that way, is attending for the training at HIW, I can 101% I can tell that, like, they are lucky enough.
That's true. Yeah.
Okay. So, obviously.
Yes.
So?
Yeah, that's true. Actually, nowadays the industry trend completely different. I don't know about earlier when I was school child or like that, but nowadays they are expecting at least in India, even though fresher, they are from fresher, they are expecting like 3 to 4 years experience thinking. Because
yes, see, actually, but the scenario is changed now.
Yes,
when before 5 years back, we used to visit all the companies and we used to request HRs like, please consider our people and please pay the salaries well. Like that, we used to request. But now the scenario is changed. Even nowadays, few MNCs are approaching us and they are asking us to customize our training based on their requirement. So the scenario has changed now. People started queuing to HRW to hire the students.
Yeah, that's true.
So this is really a blessed thing because our students are lucky enough in that way. People are coming and hiring them by just end of their 2 months training.
Yes. Generally, I also think that if you are discussing with at least 5 to 10 minutes with anybody who is experienced, that's most sufficient for me, myself, for example. I feel like that. So being institute with experienced persons, it is always a plus point. Everyone should utilize this opportunity also. Yeah. Okay. So what's plan?
So I can tell you to the people, I can tell to the people from this, through this platform, being a fresher, or for example, you have some gap, you could have prepared for government jobs and because of any reason you could have joined some other sectors and you left that and you have some 3 years, 4 years gap and you have some experience in different sectors, like you work as a site engineer or maintenance engineer, whatever the sector, and you want to move to the design field like that. So whatever this kind of cases, whoever is looking for any opportunity,
yes.
So for them, I can strongly recommend our institute to join. So the advantage with HRW is you will get whatever the required technical knowledge for next to 30 years of your career. In addition with that, you will also get a placement support.
Okay.
We also provide placements. For freshers, 100% we are providing with the placement. There is no look back in that.
Mm-hmm.
For experienced people, if anybody is bringing to our notice, they have any requirements for experienced profiles.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever the profiles we have in our records,
yes.
We are just mapping them to that. So in that way, we are supporting getting jobs for experienced people.
Yeah. So you told about 30 years up to technical knowledge. Once the person joined in HIE, you are going to support till their whenever they need, or what? How it is like that?
Yes. Actually, what is happening? For example, if a fresher is joined HIW, after 2 months he'll get a job.
Yes, that's true.
For example, after 3 years he wants to change his profile. He wants to change his company. So HIW is supporting the students not only for the placement support. We are also supporting them in terms of post-placement support.
Okay. In future,
post-placement support means in terms of getting job. In addition to the getting job also, in terms of job execution also, we are supporting them.
Okay.
For example, he needs any technical assistance. Stuck with some technical...
Yes. Yeah.
In that case, whatever, if he wants any documents or any standards or any technical support, in that way also we are supporting to our students.
Okay.
That is how we are supporting in terms of post-placement supports.
Okay. Yeah. Very nice. So what courses you are teaching there? Everything is nice. Can you explain about course pattern? What topics or subjects, what you are discussing, how the duration is, and who will be the teachers or lecturers like that? Is this offline or online, or how the situation is there?
I'll tell you. Coming to the training curriculum, we designed our training curriculum in such a way. This is suitable for any electrical core industry.
Okay.
So we are giving training on 4 modules.
Mm-hmm.
We just categorized into 4 modules, electrical system design in terms of all electrical equipment selection and sizing.
Okay.
You can say a breaker selection
mm-hmm.
and instrument transformers, electrical protection system like relays, and cable sizing calculations, transformer selection and sizing. These are all as per IS and IEC standards.
Yes, yes, yes. Yeah.
Okay, and the fault calculations with ETAP software.
Okay.
So, and after this, we are giving training on substation design up to 220 kV substations.
Okay.
Into AIS and GIS technology.
Okay. Okay.
And we are also giving training on switchgear panel design.
Okay.
And training will be given on solar PV plant design. This is what the technical part we are dealing. And in addition with that, we are also training on software part like AutoCAD, ETAP, E3, ePlan, Dialux, PVSYST, and Google SketchUp.
Yeah.
So these are the software part we are training to the people.
Okay.
So, and for this entire training, the duration, course duration is 2 months.
Okay.
And in this 2 months course, every Saturday we'll conduct a assessment test.
Okay.
And we'll assess the student's performance, how much he is learning and where he is lagging and where he is getting expertise.
Okay.
In addition with the assessment test, we are also conducting mock interviews.
Okay.
To assess the performance of the candidate before sending to the main interview.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Yes. So that should be there.
We are making people ready in terms of technical and communication skills.
Yes. Yes.
So that when he is going for the main interview, he should not look back.
Yes. That's true.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, like, we are also providing once a student join with HIW. We will, if it is an online session, we will give them a blog access. In that blog, you will have all the case studies, we have whatever the calculation documents, standards we are using in the real-time engineering. All those documents are available in the blog. And also, every day class recording sessions will be available in the blog.
Okay, okay. Yeah.
So that after completion of class, if any student has any doubts, he can go through the blog and he can listen the class again and he can clarify his doubts. And 24/7, we are our team. Generally in HIW, we have 3 to 4 members of trainers. All are having industrial experience.
Okay, okay.
So 24/7, we are assisting our students for their doubts clarification.
Okay.
Whenever they ping with any doubts, then immediately our team is readily available to give the replies.
Yes, 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 yes. Yeah, yeah.
So this is what our training.
Okay. Yeah, whatever the persons you told, for 4 or 5 people, they are dedicated staff or they are working in somewhere like you?
No, actually, 3 of us are dedicated.
Mm-hmm.
And remaining people, we call them based on the requirement. Mostly, 70% of the training will be covered by me only.
Okay, okay. Yes.
Major topics will be covered by me and remaining few topics will just take other people's support and we'll finish the sessions.
Yeah. So,
and in addition to that, every Saturday we are calling one industrial expert into our place and he will address all the students.
Okay.
He will share his experience.
Okay.
So it will help our students to grow in their professional life.
Yeah.
That is what the excellency, this is what the excellency we are making the people into their dream.
Yeah. Very nice. Yeah, Skill Desire, I seen one Skill Desire also. Is this your subsidiary or it is separate one?
No, actually, I don't want to discuss about anything on that. Actually,
okay, no, no issue. Yeah.
See, I told you, right, one of my key. Just they started their
okay, no issue. Yeah, yeah. Okay, good.
They got separated from HIW and they started their own. That's
it. Okay, no issue. Yeah.
That is one recently they started there and they are doing their own part and I'm doing my part. That's it.
Okay. Yeah. How
I think you asked me the same question in the WhatsApp also.
Yeah, because some of students or someone told me who took HIE. Training at HIE, it is a subsidiary of sister concern, something like that, they told me. So that's why.
Okay. Actually, the thing is, okay, let's not discuss more about that.
Yes,
after this.
Yes, yes. Okay. So, are you arranging any site visits or something like that, or only?
Yes. We also conduct. We are also taking students to the sites. Like we are taking students to substation visits and solar PV plant visits, and we are taking to the people like solar cell manufacturing units, module manufacturing units, and industry. Like we are taking them into the industry, and like there in a lively, we just show them like how the cabling is done and how the connections are made to the different motors, and how the switchgear panels is arranged, like transformer ratings and substation equipment, different equipments, what are the technical specifications of each and every equipment. So like that, we are just giving them a practical experience with the site visits. Almost in this 2 months training, we are providing almost 4 to 5 different sites, site visits, industrial visits.
Okay. Yeah. How people are, I mean, how industry or companies are providing support to you, if you are asking any substation person?
We are taking support from our friends and previous colleagues and all. So obviously, same as you impressed with our whatever the service we are giving. Mm-hmm. The same way, there are so many people in the industry who supports well.
Yes, when we are
approaching them, sir, we are doing the same way, then obviously people get impressed and they will welcome us like, yaar, you can come and you can utilize my space to empower the people. So, in that way, we are very happy. I'm very thankful to all my friends, all my colleagues, and all the industrial experts who is giving their valuable support in terms of time and knowledge and all this.
Yes. Only thing, we need their time.
Yeah. Exactly, because being a 30 years experienced guy, if he is spending 2 hours their time and explaining the relay concepts and all this stuff to our students, it's not an easy job.
Yes.
But people are taking the pain and giving their valuable time and knowledge to our students. In that way, they're very lucky.
Yes.
To have at least to be a friend of them.
Yeah. That's true. Being in industry for this many years, you have many people also.
Yes, and fortunately, even if any unknown person also, if I go and talk to them and I explain my concept, then they will happily accept my request and they are welcoming us. That is a great part is happening with people.
Same thing I am also doing for this.
Exactly.
good. Okay. Are you paying anything to those companies or something? Because some company may ask.
I'm not paying any single penny to anybody.
I have not paid anything. Okay.
I just consider this as a service, and they also considering this as a service, and they are giving support.
That's true. Yeah. That should be there. Otherwise,
there is no commercial terms are involved in this.
Yes. Got it.
Okay. Just it's only a matter of service motive, not
commercial. Okay, nice. So what branches of engineering you are covering? Is this only for electrical, or you are moving to
actually as I have expertise in electrical, being in a background of electrical engineering, we are giving our services only for electrical engineers now.
So
in coming maybe within 6 months or 1 year, we have a plan, because HIW is a brand for core engineers.
Our
caption itself is HIW empowering engineers. We are here to empower the engineers in terms of core sector.
Yes.
So very soon we are going to start mechanical and civil.
Okay.
Let's see.
If
we get a very good response, we also enter into few software domains like artificial intelligence and machine learning and whatever it is.
Very
soon, within 6 to 1 year, we are going to start mechanical and civil.
This mechanical and civil is mostly related with our electrical branches. Electrical products. Everything they need, their support, their structures.
If I get any very good person like who is having experience like me in their core field, then I heartily welcome them to give their valuable services adapted. If anybody is there, if anybody is looking through this media, then if you have interest to give your, to share your knowledge to the young dynamic fresh engineers, then I heartily welcome you people.
Yes, in terms of civil and mechanical. Okay, nice. So what about the placements and all? I mean, say some people are joining into your course, you are giving some placement, how you are approaching the companies? You told some of companies approaching directly to you also. Yeah, what is process there?
When it comes to the placement part, almost 90% people get the placement.
Okay.
See, that the rest of 10% also, they'll get the placements, but lack of interest and lack of focus, people get deviate and they are failed in getting the placements.
Okay.
We have our dedicated HR core team. Mm-hmm, almost five people are working only on placements.
Okay.
Yeah. So like wherever the there are openings in the industries, it will come to our notice. So based on that, we segregate the available students based on their skill set. We will send them for the interview. So the success rate is 100%, because whenever a student is going for any interview, he'll get a job. There is no look back in
that. That should be our motto. That's it.
Yes, because we are giving the required skill set based on the industrial requirement.
Obviously,
cracking the interview for our students is not a big deal. It's a cakewalk for us.
Yeah.
Okay, before sending the main interview, we are almost 3 to 4 mock interviews we are conducting at our premises with a different industry experts.
Okay.
Based on their rating, based on their review, we will make the students' expertise in the into the main interviews.
Yeah.
So that is how our students are getting success in getting the jobs.
Yes. One of your students also, he told me, how they are giving for particular. There are so many jobs in electrical also. So many fields are there. He told based on my course curriculum, my examination and all, they are giving some scores. So in which area I am performing better related to that area, they are referring jobs and all. Is this the process, right?
Suppose, see, if for example, if you are a fish can swim better way in the water. Okay. If you are just taking the fish out and if you are asking the fish to run, then it cannot.
Yes.
That's what. See, the advantage with HIW is we'll identify a candidate where he can or she can perform in a better way.
Yes.
Based on their skill set, based on their interest, we will segregate the people. Like some people are suitable for design profile. Some people are suitable for site engineers. Some people are suitable for procurement engineers.
Yes.
Some people are, whoever is very good in communication, they are good. They are suitable for business development position. So like that, we segregate the people based on the candidate's skill set. That is how we are succeeding in placing the students.
Yeah, very nice. Process is systematic.
Yes, we are very systematic and we are very sincere in giving our services, and we are very honest. We don't exaggerate ourselves. We don't want any marketing, like we don't give any fake promises, first of all.
Whatever
we can, we give. That's it.
Okay.
If we cannot do something, we don't say.
Whatever we say, we do.
That's it.
Yeah, that should be the motto.
Motto is not commercial motive. Our motto is a service motto.
Yes.
So whoever is coming to HIW, he should return to his home with a smile, with a happy face.
That's how
you can go through our reviews also. Our reviews reflect our
I seen a couple of reviews also. Yes. So what kind of companies are giving placements to these students, for example? Because there are some very high level companies, MNC, something like that. There are startups also. There are mid-level companies who started some 10 to 15 years back. So what is the range of companies are offering? Because people think that they will give some blah blah job, something like that, and they will something. Some people may have some mindset. So what you say? Exactly. What you say to those?
See, actually, as you know very well, being a fresher in electrical, especially in a core, most of the companies are offering the starting salary as a 15 to 20K.
Yes, that's true.
So, starting from small scale industries to the MNCs are coming to our institute to select the students. Recently, I should not spell the name.
Okay.
Here.
Okay.
I should not, yes, I yes, want yes. to disclose the names. Like most of the MNCs are approaching us to select our candidates because our students are trained students.
Okay.
So, starting from small scale industries, medium scale industries, and substation related companies, solar related companies, wind power plant. So I told you, our training, our people are suitable to do job in any electrical core industry. It's not only this, that.
Yes.
Could be solar substation, it could be solar, it could be oil and gas, it could be industry, it could be facility, it could be power plant, whatever it is. So all kind of industries are approaching us, and we are even successfully placing our students in all the sectors.
After taking this course, overall thinking of the student also changes. The student who I interviewed, he told, now I am the pakka electrical engineer, not earlier.
Yes. With the technical knowledge, people also get the exposure in electrical, which is the best way to approach.
Yes.
Okay. After 5 years, to which position I should be. That kind of vision people will get after this training.
Yes. The students, they themselves also can think of what field suits best them based on their interest and all.
People start thinking by their own.
Yes. You are giving that much own self-thinking also. And not only at HIE, after leaving HIE also, people are thinking on their own, self-dependent. They are independent, we can say. That much culture, exposure you are creating for the students. Also very nice. Yeah. Who can take this course? For example, there are many college students. For example, first, second, third or fourth year. Many people who just come out of the college, 1 or 2 years. Something like that. So, who can take these courses? For example, there is GATE, IES exams also. Yes, or MED EASY or some other. So many institutes are there. I've spelled a few. They are giving coaching also for an examination point of view. How your coaching is different from them? Is any college student can take these courses? Yes. Or what is the
biggest? I can tell you, whatever the training we are giving in 2 months, this is a life settlement training.
Okay.
Okay, we are saying to the fresh engineers, just spend 2 months time, you will get a job. You will be returned with an offer letter.
Okay.
So no GATE institutions, no IES institutions are giving guarantee 100% you will get a rank or 100% you will get a seat. But HIW is giving that kind of confidence to the students. It's a life settlement training, not just people are 1,000 people are joining and 10 people are getting ranks. We are not focusing those 10 people. Out of whoever is 100 people are joining with us, 90 people are returning with the placements. Yeah. Our success rate is 99%.
That should be every student should get.
See, we focus on students, on individual student, a below average student also, once he is entering into HIW, we'll make him in the right way.
That's true.
Okay. Our team will take a special focus on him, and our team will make them into a right shape. So which is how he can fulfill the industrial requirement.
Yes. That should be the motto actually.
So that is the greatness of HIW. No other people are giving this kind of guarantee, this kind of confidence to the fridge. And coming to the point, to whom this training is suitable. So our training is suitable for a fresh electrical graduates after completion of their 4-1 training.
Mm-hmm.
So we have finished their 4-1 train 4-1. So if they join with us in 4-2,
okay.
So by giving 2 months training, we are making them join as a interns in a different companies.
Okay.
So right. They are joining as an intern and they're working like 3-4 months as an interns. Once they finish their 4-2 exams and they are getting their certificates, so those companies will absorb them as a their permanent employees.
Okay. Yeah.
So this is how we are supporting fresh electrical graduates. In addition with that, whoever is passed out like 2018, 2019, 2020. So those people also, few employers are considering accepting them as a freshers.
Yes. Yeah, that's true.
They are getting training from HIEE. They're accepting them as a freshers. So we are just we are training them and we are placing them into different industries as a freshers.
Okay.
And coming to the experienced people. Even experienced also coming to the training and they are learning all the design concepts and all the detail engineering concepts here. And they are getting a very good knowledge. With that knowledge, people are getting very good jobs in the industry with their own efforts.
Yeah.
So, fresher and experienced, everyone can join with HIEE to enhance their technical knowledge in terms of industrial degree.
Yeah.
I hope I gave.
Yes. Yeah. You've given. Yes. One more thing. So, did you have any laboratory setup like that? Did you have any thought on that? Or any, because whatever you are teaching, everything, mostly some substation, some related things at component level, for example, motor or transformer or small level, it needs some different approach. So what is your measurements and control systems? There are so many things in electrical.
Yes. Actually, as you know very well, yes. When it comes to the lab part, we have few equipments. Like in a live session, we showcase all the breakers,
okay.
How the current transformer looks like, cable looks like, multimeter operation.
Okay.
And even we have some setup of like starters, like a DOL starter, star delta starters.
Okay.
So like that. But unfortunately, what happens in electrical, if you want to go with a lab setup, like it requires huge amount of space.
Yes.
And it's not even economical because, as you know, for example, if you want to install a transformer, it is almost like it occupies huge amount of space and it's not even economical.
Yes.
People like. So that is the reason. By keeping that in mind, instead of having a lab setup at our premises, we are taking the people to the sites only.
Okay, directly.
Okay.
We are
taking the people to the direct site only, and in a live substation or live solar plant, we are just making them a touch and feel like this is what the equipment is.
Yeah.
So that's where we are bridging the gap between academics and industrial requirement. That's how people are realizing the real-time engineering.
Yes. What is your plans? Do you have any plans to tie up with any colleges? Because colleges also, they are asked, for example, there are so many small companies outside, some robotics workshop or some electrical workshop or some measurements workshop, something like that. There are so many things who are offering some solar workshop, something like that. So is there any plan like that, or can you explore a few things about
that? Actually, so far we have almost like 30 to 35 colleges we have deal with MOU.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
No, one of our understanding we have with the 30 colleges, mm-hmm. all top universities, like you can say CBIT Hyderabad and NGIT, NTU, and you have like all the topmost colleges, like you can say Matsushi Engineering College and Gokaraju Rangaraju, Mallareddy institutions, like all almost across Telangana and Andhra. Not only Telangana and Andhra, we also spread to a few colleges in Karnataka, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu.
Okay.
So people are coming forward to have MOU with us.
Okay.
So that is how, it is becoming easy to approach them.
Yeah.
And that is how they are also convincing their students and sending them to our institute.
Yeah. What is plans for them? Is this a similar, everyone similar course setup? I mean, course plan, or for them little bit different, or how you can say?
Yes. See, for example, I can tell you, for example, if any industry is specifically asking for their requirements,
mm-hmm.
for example, there is one company in Mumbai, MNC.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So they want people, especially in a protection and control knowledge.
Yeah.
So what we do, like, we segregate few candidates based on their requirement.
Yeah.
And we segregate the candidates in 1:2 ratio. If they have 15 requirements, we select 30 students.
Yes.
And we customize our training based on their requirement.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So whatever the knowledge they're expecting from the students,
mm-hmm.
we are giving special training to them.
Okay.
So that it will be easy for the students to crack the interview. That is how, that is like a win-win solution.
Yeah, that should
okay.
be.
Okay, they got their required candidates, and we also happy, like our people are placing in the right place.
Yeah.
So that is how we are customizing our training based on the industrial requirement. If any industry is from solar and they're asking specific requirement, like we need a candidate having experience on PVSYST or Google SketchUp softwares.
Mm-hmm.
So we are just selecting the people from the group, and we are just making them to practice only on that part.
Okay.
So that is how they are getting expertise. Mm-hmm. Once they join into job, immediately they can start giving output.
Yes. That is
our secret mantra of success.
Yeah. Once we joined into the companies or anywhere, we should immediately be able to start. Nowadays, companies
there
have no time.
There will be a huge, there will be a huge difference between a normal fresher and a trained fresher.
Yes. That's true.
That's where our people are exploring in a better way.
Yes. Yeah. So being a owner or complete responsible person for this HIEE, what is your plan or vision for next 5 years like that? What you will think of it?
Yeah, actually my plan is like, I just want to make this, I just want to grow this institute. It's not like people are, we are going to the industries or we're going to the colleges. I just want to make a common platform. Like people will come and take the training, and employers will come and take them for the jobs. This process should become like automation.
Yes.
So I want to make a process. Okay, if somebody is entering into HIEE, they should leave with a proper job.
Yeah.
With a happy face.
Yes.
So like I don't want to make it local. I just want to make this in as a global institution. Like we had like a Nalanda, Takshila. So I just want to make HIEE in that level.
Yes. Yeah.
So definitely it is going to happen in coming 5 to 10 years, I hope.
Yes.
We are putting our efforts to make it possible, hopefully.
Yeah.
Actually, that is my dream.
That should be, yes. Yes.
Whoever is in the world, in terms of core requirement, people think about HIEE.
That's it.
What my dream. I feel like God has sent me on this globe.
Yeah.
Fulfill that requirement. Maybe.
That's true.
I think that is my last wish.
Yes.
Electrical
engineering, electrical industry, there is lack of information to the people. Yeah, that's whatever we are studying in books and all, that is completely different. But the approach, practical, it is there. That is completely different. I don't know when that practical approach we will read in schools, colleges and all. I am not sure when it will happen. After completing my graduation, after 1 year joining into one company, then I will understand that I don't know anything.
Actually, not only you and me, that is the same case is with every engineer who is coming out from the college.
Yes.
Okay, you don't believe me, like people are coming from top universities with 80%, 85%. And when people are coming to my class, when I ask the question, like, what do you mean by voltage? So even a person with 85% is not in a position to give definition for a voltage.
Yes.
That is the unfortunate thing happening in the colleges.
That's true.
So I don't want to blame
that's true.
Any person, because the system is like that. So I'm just putting my small efforts to bring a change in the society.
Yes. Yeah, that's
especially
true.
As I'm an electrical engineer, at least let me put my efforts into electrical stream.
That's true. Yeah. Myself, for example, being electrical engineer in industry for 5-6 years, now I will think that why can't I should have this understanding, little bit understanding in my second year or third year of BTech. Then I can make miracles. Because at that time, I don't know. I have a lot of time with me. I don't know anything. Why I wasted my time? I'm thinking like that.
Time will come for everything. Okay. Simply things will not happen. Okay. I welcome all the experts.
Yes, all
the core industrial experts, I welcome. Please come forward to HIW to share your valuable knowledge to empower the people in terms of industrial requirement.
That's true. Yes.
So don't leave your soul or you leave your body without sharing your knowledge. So whatever the knowledge you have, you please share to the people so that could help to the different in a different way. That is how we can empower the people. That is how you can build a powerful nation. Okay, don't be too narrow-minded. Okay, let's come forward and whatever the knowledge you have, you just share to the people.
That's true.
That is how we can build the nation.
Yeah.
That is the sincere
request. I'm like-minded people like you. I also think we are studying, we are keeping more effort by day and night for getting information and all. If you are dead one day, so everything goes out. That's it. Nothing else.
It will be disappear in the
world. That's it. Nothing else.
That's what. See, there is a purpose of every human. There is a purpose for every life.
Yeah.
I feel that this is the purpose of my life.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So I also request everyone to just think of it. Whoever may electrical or any engineers are there. Try to utilize platforms like this, these institutes who are providing practical knowledge directly. Yes. So utilize them and make use of it. Yeah, man, I have a few more things to ask you. Anybody who are there, up to this, it's clear. But anyone, how we can believe you? I mean, not believe you. We want to know a few more things about your professional background, a little bit about individual things. It may take 10 more minutes, I think. But
it's okay, no problem.
Yeah.
I'm okay.
Yeah. So some 2005 to 8, I have some your resume with me. I'm just each thing, just in 1 or 2 minutes, we will discuss. So at SSL Tech, what is your experience and all? How you joined there? I think that may be your first company. So
yes.
What is your work and all?
Yeah. Yes, I'll just, this is a very interesting part.
Yeah.
When I finished my BTech in 2005, as the same engineers, I also didn't know anything.
Mm-hmm.
And I was blank. My knowledge was zero.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know even how to approach the companies and I don't know how to think about myself.
Yeah.
But my social skills helped me out to get a job. One of my senior was working with that SSL Tech. His name is Mr. Banu Prasad Reddy.
Mm-hmm.
So he helped me to get a job in that company.
Okay.
So luckily, I just went for an interview and I got selected for that job. I started my career with a 4,000 rupees.
What is your nature of work? Yes, yes.
So I used to work in the designing.
Okay.
Okay, like I used to design switchgear.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I used to work on switchgear panels design, manufacturing, and testing.
Okay.
I work for commissioning. It's a small scale industry.
Okay.
So the advantage with the small scale industries is like you will get exposure to work with the various sectors.
That's true.
That's the reason I suggest my young engineers, if you get a chance to work with the small scale industries, you please join. Don't look for any infrastructure, or don't look for salary, and don't look for any white collar jobs.
Yeah.
Because the amount of learning in the small scale industries will be great.
Yes.
So that is about my first company. I worked there for almost 2.5 years.
Yeah. And then
after that, I joined the company called Rolta India Limited. There it's a different work profile actually.
Yeah, I didn't understand that actually. Smart plant related, it is there.
They are the pioneers of Intergraph softwares. Okay. Mm-hmm. Smart plant electrical, smart plant instrumentation. Those softwares are mostly used by oil and gas sector.
Okay. Okay.
So mm-hmm. I was the South representative for those softwares there.
Okay.
And okay. I almost work one and a half year over there.
Okay. Okay.
So, and after that, I felt like this is not going to help me out to explore my knowledge.
Yes.
I left the company.
Mm-hmm.
And again, I used to, from Rolta India Limited, I just came back to Hyderabad and joined with Aster Private Limited.
Yeah,
moved to so many companies.
Yes.
almost in my 15 years of experience, I moved almost 10 companies.
Yes.
But I never regret myself to change the companies, because every time, every company where I'm changing, I learned something new.
That's it. Learner will always learn whatever he is.
Yes. I got the opportunity to learn the things. That is the great thing happened with my whatever the company is.
Yes. What is your experience at Aster? Yeah.
Like I worked for the 33/11 kV substations in Aster.
Mm-hmm.
I did one or two projects. One is for Maharashtra Mahadiscom,
mm-hmm.
and one is for Karnataka state.
Yeah.
So there I worked for substations.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
After working 2.5 years for Aster Private Limited, I got an opportunity to work with L&T.
Okay. What is your nature of work at Aster? I mean,
My total 15 years of experience is into design and detail engineering.
Okay. Clear.
So, in the substations also, I used to prepare the single line diagrams and substation layouts, earthing layouts, lighting layouts,
mm-hmm.
and cable schedule preparation and protection control wiring diagrams. This mm-hmm. is my nature of job actually.
Okay.
With that knowledge, with that strong knowledge, I got an opportunity to work for L&T. I just started working at Qatar. I'm posted in Qatar.
Doha.
Mm-hmm. But very few days I worked for L&T. Almost it's only small period, like 1 year, 11 mm-hmm. months something I was there.
Okay.
Due to my personal constraints, again, I left L&T and I again came back to Hyderabad.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
In the year of 2010.
Yeah.
So once I returned back from L&T, I started HIAA.
Okay.
With that technical knowledge and with that technical background, with my colleagues and all the support, I started HIAA. From there, parallelly, I used to work and I used to give the sessions and the trainings to the students.
Yeah, that parallel work related, what is your exposure at RK Electric?
See, like after starting this HIAA, I got an opportunity to work with RK Electric Automation. The reason actually why I did like a parallel things, because totally dedicate my time to institute, I don't get an opportunity to
learn,
know the latest industrial practices.
That's true.
Okay, yes. My learning will stop there only.
Yeah.
So, to avoid that, to know the things, what are the updates is happening in the electrical system design and engineering. So, to know the updates, to learn the things, to explore the things, I used to work parallel.
Yeah,
that is how I used to learn the things in the job, and I used to explain those things in the classes.
But all are almost a little bit different. How you will manage? I mean, it's only learning and doing, or how you have, for example.
No, it's not learning and doing. I used to give my knowledge to the different projects. Like, for example, as I told you, like, I work for substations, I work for solar power plants, I even work for switchgear panels. See, actually, in that way, I'm so lucky.
Yes.
Because everyone will not get this many opportunities to learn. Like, I work for substation, like, I work for AIS substations. I got an opportunity to work for GIS substation.
Yeah.
And when it comes to the solar also, I work for ground mount. In the ground mount also, I work for various technologies like ground mount fixed tilt, ground mount like a seasonal tilt, a tracker, and a rooftop. When I was joined with the TMAC, Toshiba Mitsubishi, I used to work at the inverter side manufacturer.
Japan.
So I don't know, like it's a God has given me this opportunity to learn so many things to share with the people. Maybe that could be the reason I got so many opportunities.
So I'm very
happy for that.
So many things you covered.
Yes.
Yeah.
Within short time.
That's that is the one point. Yeah.
Because in 15 years, covering this many areas is quite difficult.
Quite difficult.
But I'm very blessed to do that.
Yeah, only your interest towards this field.
That's made it. Like I never feel like a job security, and I never felt like, "Arey, if I lose this job, then what to do?" Not like that.
That's it.
Okay, I even don't care about job, because I just move in my way, and things also in that way.
That's it.
God has supported me in that way. I can tell you that.
Yeah. Very nice,
Madan. That credit is goes to God.
That's very nice, Madan.
Instead of taking my personal credit, I just leave it to God.
Okay. Yeah, in Hyderabad, where it is located, HIWE?
Actually, our institute is located at Hisar Nagar, just nearby Maitri Vanam.
Mm-hmm.
And it is located in a very primary location.
Okay.
With 2000 SFT is our institute area.
Okay.
And we have beautiful classrooms with virtual classroom also. We are
available. Yeah.
So at a time, offline plus online classes will be conducted at HIWE.
Yeah.
So in addition with that, we have very good staff rooms. And,
yes.
I have a great staff with me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just want to give this credit to my staff even.
Yes. That's true.
Without their support, I couldn't reach to this level.
Yes. That's true.
Every time, my employees will support me. Like if I'm doing anything wrong, then they will come and take the advantage, and they'll suggest me, "Sir, don't do like this. Let's go in this way." So that kind of support is available from my staff. Yeah. Like we are like a Google. We don't feel like I'm the boss, you are the employee.
That's it. That should be the nature, actually.
Okay, so we just move in that way. That's it.
What is the maximum strength you can accommodate directly?
Almost 15 members team.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Generally, how many teams you will start? I mean, monthly, 1 or 2 months? What is the plan actually?
Actually, we start every month. We'll start a batch.
Okay. So daily, how many hours a student or anyone has to spend for this?
Daily classes will be 4 hours.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And class will start from morning 8 o'clock, 8 to 10 and 11 to 1.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
After having lunch, we'll ask our students to sit for the practice.
Okay.
We'll provide the laptops and desktops to them.
Whoever
is having their laptops, they'll bring their laptops and they'll start practice. Whoever is not having their own laptops and all, we give our lab to them. So they'll practice half day.
Yes. Very nice. Yo, did you have any plan of any another branch like that or what? In any Andhra Pradesh?
So far, no.
Okay.
Because due to COVID situation, like we got a wonderful opportunity, like
online sessions. That's it.
Okay. So we are even we are successfully executed 3 to 4 batches, online batches.
Okay.
And we found it is a better platform to explore the things.
That's it.
So you can connect anywhere in the world to anybody.
Yeah. Yes.
So there is no point in having like a franchises and branches and all that stuff.
Okay.
Just sit in your house and you can explore. You can connect to the world. That's it.
Straightforward. That's
we
it.
Have, we made our classroom as a virtual classroom.
Mm-hmm.
So you can happily sit in your house and you can enjoy the classes. You can learn. That's it.
Okay. Yeah. I think for software standard laptop mandatory, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So I would recommend. Okay.
Yes.
Being an engineer, everybody should have one laptop with an internet connection. That's the minimum requirement.
Yeah. Okay.
To explore the world, you have to get it. Otherwise, there is no point.
No point. Yeah. So software standard, how we will deploy? For example, I want to join. So I am somewhere else. AutoCAD. You want to teach? I want to practice. So are you installing or how you are doing those things?
Yeah. See, nowadays everybody is available with what trial versions are available.
Yes. Okay.
This AutoCAD is available with the student version. Is giving almost like a 2 to 3 years access.
Yeah.
If you have a real intention, then it's not a big deal for learning. That's it.
Okay, good.
So everyone is giving trial versions, so you can have the access. Like our people are explaining here, and you can happily sit in your home and practice this.
Okay, right.
See here, intention is the only matter.
That's it. It's under.
If you have a proper intention, learning is not a big deal.
It's very clear. Yeah. Okay. Very nice, Madan. So many things you clearly shared. Yeah, it is around 15 years of your industry exposure and all. So it is not a single day. You spend so much time, maybe in the good and bad times, you have the thinking in with you. Yeah, very nice. You shared everything. I hope this content is very useful to many people. Graduates and all, they can utilize this. Yeah, we will meet in any other session also in future. This is not the end, I can say. This is just a
start. I always welcome you to my premises. If you are coming to Hyderabad, you please
sure.
Once.
Yes.
I'm very sure you likes it.
Yeah, sure. Definitely, I will visit once. Yeah, whenever I am coming to that place. Thank you, Madan, very much
for considering me to make a part of your ALP talks.
I'm very
happy for this.
Yes. Debate. Yeah. Good. Thank you. Yeah. Nice, dear.
Thank you.
Yeah.
See you.
Bye.
Thank you, guys. This is about SAWE and about Madan Mohan. I hope you enjoyed this content. Yeah, this video may be lengthy, but I hope it given some good understanding to you what things are there. So his entire year of 15 years of experience, it's difficult to put in 1 hour, but we made like that. Yeah, if you need any contact details in anything, I provided in the description, LinkedIn contacts and all, so you can contact him directly also. Thank you, guys. Thanks for watching. In next video I will be with you. Yeah, if you didn't subscribe to this channel, please subscribe to it. Press the bell icon so that I will get notification whenever I'm uploading the videos. Thank you, guys. Bye.